In this episode of B.Hooked Knitting, we're going to knit the Tranquility Shawl sponsored by Red Heart Yarns. My name is Brittany, and I'll be your guide throughout this tutorial. For the supplies list and written instructions, please visit knitting.behookedcrochet.com/tranquility. Let's begin. We're going to begin our shawls with the long tail cast on. We don't have to worry about having a super long tail in this case because we're just casting on 3 stitches. So I would recommend just pulling about 12 inches. That'll give you enough to make your stitches and weave in your ends. To make the long tail cast on, what I do is just drape the yarn over your needle. And then you're going to orient your hand so you have your index and your thumb in between the strands, and you're securing it down at the bottom. Now, I do have slower videos available on the long tail cast on. If you're brand new to this, you can go to knitting.behookedcrochet.com/longtail. That's going to give you a really detailed tutorial on how to do this cast on. What you're going to do at this point is you want to steady that loop on the top of your needle with your finger. You're going to pull the needle down and forward, and you're going to grab that loop on the front of your thumb. Now, don't drop it off of your thumb. You'll reach around and grab the loop on your index finger. Then you'll release your thumb over the tip of your needle. Now, that counts as 2 stitches on our needle. We just need to do that one more time. So we'll pull down and around, grab that loop, go back, grab the loop on your index finger, and pull it through. So the concept of this shawl is pretty simple. What we're going to do is we're going to repeat the same 4 rows while increasing up to the middle of the shawl, and then we're going to repeat the same 4 rows decreasing down. So what we're doing is we're working from side to side on this design. So to get that started, you just want to get your yarn in hand. We're just going to be working with the knit stitch for this entire shawl. So this is a really great project to practice your knitting skills. The first row is just going to be a little foundation, just something to get us to start off. What we're going to do is we're going to knit all 3 of the stitches. Row 2 is where we're going to start our increase. So this is going to be the first row of our 4-row pattern repeat. The first thing that we want to do is knit the first stitch. And then we're going to make one. We're going to make one left. It's a little bit difficult to get this stitch the first time around for this first row because that bar that we're catching is a little bit more difficult to see when we have a very small foundation like we have here. To make one left, we need to locate the bar that's in between our 2 stitches. And like I said, it's really difficult to see here, but we're just going to grab that bar and then place it on our needle. Now you want to pay close attention to how this is oriented on the needle. Then we're going to insert our needle into the back loop of that stitch and knit. Now there we've created an extra stitch, so we've increased by 1. And then we're just going to knit the next 2 stitches. The 2nd, 3rd, and 4th row of our pattern repeat are all the same. All we're going to do is knit every stitch. Now the third row of our pattern repeat, again, we're going to knit each stitch. And the fourth row of our repeat, again, we're going to knit every stitch. Now, as we progress through this design, you'll find that it's going to get much easier to knit. It's really difficult to handle these just a few stitches and work through, but if you can just get through the first probably four or so pattern repeats, then you'll be good to go. It's going to get much easier as we go along. Now, one thing to keep in mind with this design is we're always going to increase on the same side of the shawl. So we're going to have one side that comes out at an angle, and then we're going to have one side that's straight. So this is our straight side here. This is our angled side here. That's one way that you can tell that you're on the right track. If you're having problems counting your rows and keeping track of the pattern repeat, that's one visual cue for you to know that you're on the right track. So now we're going to just repeat our stitch pattern. The first row we're always going to increase, but we need to knit that first stitch first. And now here you can get a better picture of the bar that we use to increase. So it's that top bar that just goes horizontally from one stitch to the other. You can see it right there. So take your needle from the front and just grab a hold of that bar and then place it on your opposite needle in that direction. Then you're going to insert your needle into the back of that stitch, so the back loop, and then knit. So that's your one increase. Now you're just going to knit the remaining stitches. Now again, rows 2, 3, and 4, we're just going to knit every stitch. Now here we've come to the end of another pattern repeat. It's still a little bit difficult to tell the shape, but we know that this is the straight edge and this is the diagonal edge. So this is going to be where our increases are. That's how we know we're on the right track. So our next row, we're just going to repeat again. We'll go through this just one more time. You're going to knit the first stitch, find that horizontal bar in between the two stitches, place that on your needle, knit through that back, and then knit the remaining stitches. And again, rows 2, 3, and 4 of our repeat are going to just have us knit every stitch. Now at this point, I've finished up our second, third, and fourth row of that repeat. And this is what we have so far. And I just wanted to point out how you can find those increases. So if you look here, you can see there's a little hole here and here. So here and here. These are our increases. When we're working with the garter stitch, whenever we do a make one, it's not going to be an invisible increase. So we can see these little holes, and that's okay. That actually adds to the design of this shawl. But what that does and why that's important to you is because that's going to help you in your counting. So let's say you're working on this, you have a lot longer, you know, your shawl is much longer than this, and you forget which row that you're on, or you get distracted, you have to put it down. So how can you figure out where you are? And what I would recommend is just to find that last hole and then count up your rows from there. That's going to help you to figure out where you are if you just are completely lost. One thing I would suggest is, especially if you're brand new, you're not really that comfortable with counting, there's a couple things you can use. You can use a row counter. And that's every time you finish a row, you'll just hit a button, and that's going to keep track of what row you're on. And from there, you can figure out exactly which part of the pattern repeat you're in. The other thing I would suggest, if you don't have a row counter or you just don't think that you'll remember to hit that button every single row, what I would recommend is that you stop at the same point every single time. So whenever I put my shawl down, what I was doing is I was ending on the fourth row. So that way I knew every time I pick up my shawl, I had to do an increasing row and I was restarting my pattern repeat. So those are a couple of tips. And from now, all we need to do is just knit the bulk of our shawl. We're gonna break our shawl down into three sections as far as the color goes. We're going to work with color A, which we have here, until our shawl measures 30 inches from here all the way up to the top. Once you reach that point, then we're going to play with some color. We're going to add in a couple of rows of color. We'll have color B, color C, and color D that we're going to work with. That's going to be 12 inches long. Then what we're going to do is we're going to work back with this color A for the decreasing, the final part, that's going to be 30 inches as well. So the entire length of our shawl from side to side is going to be about 6 feet. And that's what we want to do at this point. We want to get our first color section completed. So what we need to do is work this until it measures 30 inches from bottom to top. Go ahead and get that done. Come back to the video and we'll talk about the next section of our shawl. So what I've done off camera here is I've knit my shawl so that it measures 30 inches from the start to where I am right now. Now we're going to start working with these color transitions, and I'm going to demonstrate how we're going to do that and talk a little bit about the pattern itself and how you need to repeat the next few rows. So the first thing that you want to do is grab color B. I'm going to show you a little knitting hack to add on a new color that's much easier than some of the other methods. You're just going to take your working yarn in your hand and then just simply tie your new yarn around that strand. So I usually knot it twice. And then you can just slide that knot right up next to your work. Now that's how you're going to transition colors for all of the repeats. For the next 12 inches, we're going to repeat until our shawl measures 12 inches from where we are now, from this first color transition, and then we're going to transition back to our color A in the solid pattern repeat. Now you're not going to want to fasten off or bind off cut this color A, because the way our color pattern works is we're going to do two rows with color B, and then we're going to do two rows with color A. The other thing you want to keep in mind when moving forward is that now we're going to be keeping track of a color pattern repeat as well as maintaining that stitch pattern repeat. We're going to be transitioning through our colors, as the pattern indicates, for 6 more inches of our shawl. So at that point, we're going to maintain the same stitch pattern that we've been working on, where we're increasing on the first row, the second, third, and fourth rows are no increase, just knit all the stitches. What we're going to do with our color pattern repeat is we're going to knit two rows with our contrast color and then two rows with our main color. And then we're going to alternate through our contrasting colors. What I need for you to do at this point is knit your first two rows using color B. Now, once you've knit your two rows with contrasting color B, you'll just have one single row. So kind of like this one single row of bumps. And that's what we're going for here. We're going to do the contrast color, and then we're going to jump back to our main color. And we're going to do that since we didn't fasten off or bind off or anything like that. All we need to do now is just pick up that strand of yarn. So we have, of course, our tail here. This is my working yarn for contrasting color B. And all I'm going to do is just pick up color A and start knitting with that again. Now what I've done is I've knit two rows working in our color A, our main color, and this is the right side of our work. So we're going to see these little lines, these stripes, as we progress through this pattern. So we're not going to cut our main color. We're going to leave that there, but we can go ahead and trim color B. You'll want to leave yourself a long enough tail so that you can weave it in. The other thing I recommend doing is taking that first strand and making a knot with the tail that you just cut off. So just getting it situated there. So just tie those two ends. And that's just going to keep things secure. Make sure your stitches don't come out or anything like that. Then what you'll do is you'll weave these ends once we get finished with the shawl, or you could do it as you go along. Now I'll demonstrate real quickly what we're going to do with the next part of our color pattern. We're going to switch over to color C, and we're going to add that on the same way that we did before. So we'll just tuck these color B ends behind, and you're just going to want to tie it on to your main color. Now once you have that color C added on, you're going to knit two rows with color C, and then you're going to transition and knit two rows with color A. So this is just what we covered with color B here. The only difference, of course, being that we've added a new color. Once we finish those four rows, we're going to trim color C, and we're going to add color D, just like I demonstrated here. So we're not going to cover that in the video. That part is all just a repeat. What we're going to do is we're going to repeat this color pattern sequence where we do color B, then main color, color C, main color D, and main color, working in two row segments each. And we're going to work in our same stitch pattern where we're increasing until our shawl measures starting from this point here, starting from our first color transition. We want it to measure 6 inches long. So that's what I need for you to do at this point. Go ahead and work your color transitions using that same increasing stitch pattern until you can measure from your starting point here to 6 inches. All right, so what I have done off camera is I went ahead and knitted my little section here of color repeats. I continued in my increasing pattern, which is what we want to do, and now we're ready to transition. Now we're gonna stay with our same color pattern, but instead of increasing, we're gonna decrease. So what we've done is we've reached the middle point of our shawl right here. Now you should have ended on your second row for whatever color it was that you ended up with after you've achieved 6 inches from this starting point here all the way. So I'm actually in the middle of my color pattern repeat as well. And from here, like I said, what we're going to do is we're going to discontinue our increasing pattern. So we're no longer going to do that, but we're really just going to be changing up one thing. We're still going to be working with a 4-row pattern repeat. But instead of doing a make one left at the beginning of that first row, we're going to knit two together. So let's see how you do that. The first row of our new pattern repeat is going to begin with a knit two together. And the way we want to do that is we're going to take the first 2 stitches and we're going to insert our needle knitwise into both of those stitches. And then we'll just knit them as usual. Sometimes these knit two togethers can be a little bit tricky, a little hard to get your yarn worked through there. But once you do a few of them, you'll get really comfortable with them and you'll probably get much better, more comfortable with the stitches. So after we've done that on our first row, everything else is the same. For the remainder of row one of our new pattern repeat, we're going to knit all stitches. So what I've done off camera here is I've just knit my first row of our new pattern repeat, our stitch pattern repeat. A couple things that you want to keep in mind as you're working this third section of our shawl is that you want to continue to maintain your same color pattern repeat. So what we covered in the last section, we're going to be working with our contrasting colors and our main colors with 2 rows at a time. So we're going to keep that going for the next 6 inches of this third section of our shawl. But instead of using that increasing pattern like we just previously did, we're going to be using the decreasing pattern. The first row of our new pattern repeat, again, it starts with that knit two together and then we knit all stitches. So like I said, that's the point where I'm at now. I'm going to continue with row number 2 in my main color. So this is going to be my second row with this color. And all we need to do is knit every stitch. Now, once you get to the end of your second row, you're going to add on your next contrasting color and you're going to knit 2 rows with that, which are going to be the first row and the second row of your pattern repeat. So what we need to do moving forward is, once again, we're going to work this third section until it measures 6 inches from where we are now. So at that row where we made our last increase, that is going to be our starting point, our starting measuring point for this third section. We want to work our same color pattern repeat with this new stitch pattern repeat for 6 inches. So all we're doing is making a mirror image of the last section that we just completed. You're going to maintain your color pattern and maintain your stitch pattern. And once you get finished with that section, then come back to the video. We just have one more section to cover with the tutorial and our shawls are almost complete. Once you've finished with the third section, you'll see that now our shawls are starting to work its way downward. It's gonna get a lot faster from here. We just have one more section to cover What I've done is I have measured, it's about 6 inches from where we started this third section to where I am right now, and that matches the other side. We do want to have this little color section centered in our shawls. So once you have that worked out, we're going to continue working our shawl with our main color now, and we're going to work in the same stitch pattern repeat that we did for these color transitions, the only difference being that we're going to stay with this color. So once you're to the point where you're ready to start working on this last section, we're going to start over with our stitch pattern repeat wherever we are. So we want to make sure that we measure from our starting point to where we are now is about 6 inches. We're going to begin our stitch pattern repeat by knitting two together. So I'm going to knit two together for row one on the very first stitch. And then we'll proceed with this row by knitting every stitch. Now, once you've made it to the end of your first row in this fourth section, we're going to proceed with rows 2, 3, and 4 by knitting every stitch. So again, this is really the same stitch pattern sequence that we've been working with these color transitions, but of course we're just sticking with the main color. Now all we need to do to finish up our shawls is just to finish this last section. What we're going to do is on the first row, we're going to knit two together and then knit the remaining stitches. On rows 2, 3, and 4, we're going to knit every stitch. Once you get that finished, go ahead and come back to the video. We'll talk briefly about how we can weave in all of the ends from our color transitions here. We'll look at the finished product. At this point, what I've done is I have finished knitting the fourth section of my shawl, and I have just 3 stitches remaining. That's what we need to do before we bind off. We want to continue knitting until we have 3 stitches remaining. That way it's going to match what's on the other side. Now, when you're ready to bind off, what we need to do is knit the first stitch, then we'll knit the second stitch, and then we're going to grab that first stitch and pull it over the second one. Now we'll knit the last stitch, and then pull that first stitch over the last one. Now we can go ahead and trim. And pull that tail through that last loop on our needle to secure it. Now the final step is just to weave in the ends from our color transitions, and I'm going to demonstrate how to do that next. The first thing you want to do is make sure you have the wrong side of your shawl facing up. So we're going to weave in the ends on the wrong side of the work. Just start at any end, thread that on your darning needle, and then we're just going to work it through the stitches. I just tend to go back and forward. And you want to try to make sure you're weaving in the end under some stitches that have a matching color. Then once you've gone forward in one direction, it's always a good idea to go ahead and go back in the opposite direction just for a little extra security. Then you can trim that off, and you'll just want to repeat that until you have all of your ends woven in. There's an optional step of blocking that's going to improve the shape. So what you would do at that point is just pin the entire shawl down on something that is a water-safe surface. I typically use athletic flooring tiles, and you'll saturate it with water, pin it down, and then let it air dry overnight. That's really going to help relax the stitches, stretch things out. It's going to get it to stay into a really nice, perfect position. I'm so glad you knit your shawl with me today. I'm really excited to see your photos. So you can find me on social media at B.Hooked Knitting and share your pictures with me, your progress. If you have any questions whatsoever, you can feel free to leave them on my website. That link for this pattern here is knitting.behookedcrochet.com/tranquility. You can leave your questions and your comments there and share your photos on social. I also want to say a big thanks to our sponsor, Red Heart Yarns, for not only providing a really great yarn for this project, but for making this tutorial happen. On behalf of BHookedCrochet.com as well as RedHeart.com, I'm your host, Brittany. I hope to see you in the next tutorial.